Alright, play first. Yes.
Four
Morgan.
lands hands are the worst.
Yeah, but I mean, can you mulligan this?
No, I don't think so.
If we draw like a one drop, then this hand will actually be fine.
There's not a lot of spells that we wouldn't be happy with here.
Yeah, yeah.
Just any non-land card I think is
Yeah.
helpful.
Yeah.
Unleash? Well.
Rakdos Cackler.
Unleash the beast. Okay.
Don't expect that from his deck. Then again, I shouldn't really try to predict what's in his deck considering there's Xur-Tozzel Swan.
And Slaughterhorn.
Yeah.
Slaughterhorn's not bad though.
Slaughterhorn's definitely like a reasonable card. Xur-Tozzel Swan like a little bit less though.
In this deck, like Gigagross's probably better than Slaughterhorn, but possibly not in his deck because he does need if he has like too many only too many Blood Rush guys, he does or is that what's called Blood Rush? Yeah.
We're not blocking ice
No, we're not
again.
blocking.
Yeah. Unfortunate. All right, that was a
Not so
good draw.
much.
That was a draw.
Yeah, that was a good draw.
Take eight. Maybe you shouldn't have made a face Searing Spear. People just really want to F6.
F8. You can still F6 with your Searing Spear in hand.
Yeah. Yeah, F8 is the greatest button of all time. Those of you who don't know, F8 just passes priority whenever you're tapped out and have nothing to play. Like, it'll still, if you have like a Slaughter Pact or something, it'll still let you do it. It's annoying in this deck when you have Experiment 1 with two counters, the F8 doesn't work. Even though the odds of you regenerating are pretty small.
I think that's actually a legitimate reason not play the deck.
Yeah.
You're choosing between a deck that like mono red without
Yeah,
experiment on.
exactly. It's definitely a deal breaker. So this game the race seems a little bit more in our favor, but you never know. He could deal a lot of damage out of nowhere. If he has like something that gives double strike, like this could be an unknowable amount of damage.
The Boros Charms or Chastwind
I don't think he's playing, considering how many basics he has, I think it's safe to say he's solidly in red green. But you
deck. Which
never
one he plays
know.
the Plains?
All right. So what does this Plinth 4 do to our attacks? Besides completely destroy them. Creature, creature, creature.
Pamela Captain? No.
Cavern of Souls, perfect. So we can swing with the team. We put him to three. I guess that's good.
How do we put them with you? Oh, you want a Flame Maul or a Haste?
Well, I don't know, it's an option.
Oh, yeah, it's an option. Then we're dead to Xur-Tozzel Swine. We really are, though.
3, 5, 7, no.
12.
Oh, 12, yep. But I mean, the longer the game goes, the worse it gets for us, right? Like, I guess one option is swing with these, and then he takes 6, and goes to 5, and then we just second main phase this. Then we don't die to Xur-Tozzel Swine.
Yeah.
But then if he decks with everything, we have to chump block with Lightning Mauler, it's not like a long-term
No,
plan.
we don't have to jump block, we can trade.
Oh, trade Mauler for a Cackler? Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Do you like that better? The problem is then if we draw like a random creature, we can't haste it. If we do Mauler attack with the team, he'll eat a Mauler, and then jeez.
We're not charging.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
So I'm leaning towards a pair. Well, five. I'm leaning towards attack, no pair. Attack and then play Mauler without no pair. But I'm willing to listen to other options also.
Attack, play Mauler, no pair. Okay, so.
He'll be at 5, we'll have an untapped Mauler, tap 2 Boros Elites, and he'll have this. And if he swings with the team, we can decide whether we want to take it or block. Probably block. And if he doesn't, then at least, like, we have a chance to draw a creature, like Hamlet Captain or something.
Yeah.
You like that?
Yeah. Well, Hamlet Captain wouldn't kill him, right?
Depending
we need
on...
to draw a haste creature, and there's only two.
Well, no, I'm saying the Mauler will be unpaired. So this Mauler
maybe
will...
won't block?
If he attacks with everything, maybe we'll block. But I'm not sure. I haven't thought that far ahead.
Because the problem is, if he attacks with everything, and...
I think we probably just take it, and just, like...
And just die. In that case, we want to play Lightning Mauler, right? Right now. Put him at 3 instead of 5.
No, this is still better, because it's unpaired. So, like, it makes it so that we, any creature we drop will have haste.
Okay.
And, like, it'll deter him from attacking, at least. Potentially. I'm not sure, though. It's, like, an interesting...
I think we were just dead to Zurchar Swine. Anyways.
Well, if we're not blocking them, yeah, we're dead to Zurchar Swine anyway. The question is... But then this play is still better if we draw, like, if Hamlet Captain's our top card. But if land's our top card, then it's better that... It would have been better for me to play Lightning Mauler, so... I'm
yeah.
not really sure. It's good that we lived through Gorkland. That's at least something relevant.
Not Slaughterhorn of our clan.
Like yeah, I mean...
Don't live through it even if we block.
Yeah, I mean, that's unrealistic.
And it, hopefully it just blocks our Boros Elite.
Yeah, I mean, depending on his hand, that's not a completely unreasonable play. We really need to draw a creature there.
Yeah.
If we draw, like...
Bricking there was bad.
If we draw Hamlet Captain, I think he's literally dead.
Mayor, too.
Yeah. Mayor, he's dead. There was a lot of cards that just killed him there. And then,
almost
like,
any creature.
Yeah, most creatures would kill him.
Flint of War.
Would that kill him? That one I'm not sure about.
Yeah, sir would kill him.
3, 5, 7, 10. I don't think it would.
We just play land. We'd kill him.
What?
Oh,
no,
yeah,
I know.
So he would block a 3-3.
Yeah, and he would take...
One.
Yeah, I think he would go to 1. But he'd be in an insurmountable position. Even second Lightning Mauler probably would have done the trick.
Yeah. Was there a reason to play a land there?
I'm not sure. Like... It makes it seem like it makes it seem more like we have a spell in hand, I guess, but other than that, I don't know.
We have a 4-drop.
Yeah.
And you or I mean a 5-drop.
Like, yeah, we could have like Gorkland Rampager in hand, that's really. But
I think our best chance, like, this game was to play Lightning Mauler, attack for with everything, just hope he doesn't have Zurchar Swine.
Well, then he'd be at 3.
Yeah.
But then, like, even so, if he just plays a blocker here, then, like, we're still in a terrible spot, and we can't draw a creature, or a creature won't be as relevant, because we won't be able to haste it. Whereas, like, this way we can haste it. Oh, jeez.
Alright.
So we're no blocking? I'm so sure he has it. Maybe our better bet is to block it and hope to draw a haste creature.
Well, how many haste creatures are there? We boarded out a couple Lightning Maulers and...
No, we boarded out... We have all the Lightning Maulers. We boarded out 2 Flint of 4. So there's 6 haste creatures.
There's Flames also.
Flames of the Firebrand, yeah. I'm gonna block.
We are blocking now?
Yeah, I decided. I think it's better. In all retrospect. Right.
Alright.
Well, Flames probably won't be an out because they'll probably have a blocker here, yeah.
Oh god. Oh god.
Alright, now we're pretty much dead.
Yeah, I mean... Do we have anything else at this point?
Not that I know of. So if he swings with the team here, we just probably chump bore with an elite and let the rest through, and then at least pretend that we have Warclan Rampager as an out or something. I don't know.
pretend to win.
Yeah, you don't like winning for pretend. Like, I don't think it's better to chump block everywhere. Like,
yeah, I mean, you can draw, like, if he has anything, we're dead, so. Which, he could have had anything.
Or if he has nothing, we're also dead. Well, the last turn, he had to have, like, specific cards. This turn, the, like, number of cards that kill us is dramatically higher. Yeah, well, I'm sorry for a bit of an unfortunate display from this deck. I guess the first match we played, you got to see the deck's true power. But yeah. So yeah, as far as changes go, what do you think, Char?
I want Searing Spear.
You want Searing Spear back, yeah. So you want to cut Thunder 4 for it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's good. I definitely like Captain more than Boar.
I still like Captain, and I still like Wolf and Captive.
Yeah. The other thing I kind of want is more one drops, even though there are
not many options. 16,
but I'm not really sure if Reckless Wave is Fling. Jeez, his deck's sweet. All right, well, we're dead.
Boar draws. What are we drawing?
Oh yeah, we should check. That's important. Very important. Champion, Fiend Hunter, not very good. You can just keep drawing our whole deck. It's not going to change very much.
So, there's the new health program.
Yeah, the Near East were both at the very bottom. So yeah, so we're thinking, like, going back to Searing Spear over Flint of Boar. The sideboards felt pretty good. Maybe a third Rule Charm, I like that card a lot. But yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed this, even though it wasn't too successful. And Shahar may be staying with me in the future, since there's a stretch of Grand Prix coming up, so you guys may get to hear more of him.
Yeah, we might do some drafts.
Drafts.
If you guys have suggestions of what you want us to do, what format.
Any format, any deck. We're about
not,
pretty
not
flexible.
Legacy, not Modern Eggs, but anything else.
Yeah, playing a combo on Magic Online is not always optimal. Alright, see you guys next time.